Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales, and welcome back to the Wales campaign on Total War Medieval 2 on very hard difficulty. So, in the previous episode, we took Carlisle from the English and we defeated an English army here in the north. This has given me a big hold now on the north. I can now go for the likes of Newcastle and York and try and push the English back all the way. We are currently being besieged at the fort, which is a bit of a strange one for my liking. Although Vortable Howell is trapped there after his exploits in trying to take Nottingham. So we may need to help him out. We will try to escape maybe, I don't know. Captain Ridrich has a catapult on the way anyway, so we'll send him there. See if he can help, but doubt he can. This large army is going to go for London, I think. Although saying that, it's probably wiser to go for Nottingham with this army. So I've changed my mind, they're going to go there. My spies are in position, I can see plenty at the moment. The reason I'm doing this is because Canterbury is going to be taken by this army, hopefully. And Llywelyn is sitting in striking distance to London. And he can take London in this part. I think that's exactly what I'm going to do. Although the ballista does stop him getting there. So what I'm going to be doing is attacking London. The king has risen. He's going to attack London this part. He's there ready, waiting. Oxford needs some units to help them, I think. So let's send one there. They're still not happy. Got plenty of units in Oxford, mind you. So why are they unhappy? Let's have a little look. Insurgents, unrest, distance to the capital, squalor. We could probably put them on low. Let's see. That does help quite a bit. Tax bonus. That will help for now. We will build some stuff for these guys as well. Maybe a blacksmith. Maybe a church. A church wouldn't be a bad idea. We'll go for a church. We'll build that for them. So they'll have land clearance and then a church. That will help out tremendously. So this army, Captain Carrad out to Nottingham. The king will get to London in the next part. And I want the king to take London himself. Because he deserves it. It would be great if he could. This battle will probably be in the next part or next turn. So we got that to look forward to at Canterbury. They got some units, but they militia mainly. Got some ballista and knights as well. Yeah, so that's fine. Should be okay there. But now, we must probably end turn before long. So I'm just going to check everything very quickly. Oh, this one is going to be taken as well as fort. I have a merchant as well. 40% chance on him. 27 on him. 21 on him. So I can use my merchant. May as well do it. 40% chance. Yay, look at that. Successful acquisition. And we got some money for that as well. So that's great. They have rebel share. Peasants. Not too much of an issue, I don't think. We got some Gwent Raiders there to help out. They haven't attacked me yet, so I'm not too worried. My merchant can probably go south, maybe. Try and take these out. Probably an idea. We'll do that. And the rest are pretty happy with my reign, so I think we're okay. My concern's in the centre here. I've got a feeling there's a large army around here. I need to get a spy there as quickly as I can. Daikin will get there in the next turn. Because Oxford could be in danger again. And if it is, Captain Caradog might have to come back to help out. But anyway, I will now be ending turn to turn 19. And they've sallied out to Canterbury. So we will be fighting for Canterbury in this episode. And there are some armies reinforcing as well. There are actually one army's reinforcing. 31 men and 191 against 242. How will Garonwy? We got bows, we got Merinoise spearmen, we have Rafelwyr axemen. I think we'll be okay. I could auto-resolve this, but I'm going to fight this one anyway. I'll try to fight as much or most of the battles. I will even fight the London battle, even though that should be straightforward, considering that I have a much bigger army, and I think London only got two units. Although one of them is the king, and I'd love to take the king out with my own king. So we're going to be doing that. And they've come out straight away, so we're going to quickly drop this. We're going to get the bow selected, put them into a group, put them into a formation, put them onto fire at will, get the general, send him to the right flank. We're going to grab all our units, we're going to put them into a formation, We're going to reform them into a single line. And then, where are they? They are straight for us, coming straight for us. They're there. And this is a perfect opportunity, because they've only got the knights. We've got a perfect opportunity here, guys. Attack. All the spearmen attack. All the bows attack. General can be going to the right flank. Not yet, actually. Perfect. This is perfect. This is perfect. And now, cavalry charge from the flank. All my bows on fire at will. They're not firing for some reason. Fight into the death. They have lost half. I could actually take the city. It's time to press the attack. Oh my god, we've taken him out. The enemy general. All the horses are dying. Look at that. If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy. That was perfect, because I trapped the AI then. And the gates are open as well. We can actually go and take the settlement. Let's run everything in. Let's take it quickly before they get there. Took the general out. Gates are open. Get in there. They are miles away. We can take this without actually fighting them. This is perfect. If we look up here, where are they? Look how far away they are. They are all the way back here. They won't stand a chance. Get my general to run. I'm going to run my troops in. I want to take this quickly. I'm going to fast forward this, of course, as well. Once I actually get in the settlement. There we go. Fast forward. Got to come around to get into the settlement. We can steal Canterbury from them. My lord, our men are in command of the city. We're going to be stealing Canterbury. Holy crap. I'm actually going to select the bows. For some reason I can't take the tower though. Where's that? Let's get the Hellweird bowmen on the walls. They're going to come through that gate or try to, so we'll do that. But that, we should be taking this anyway, so it's not much of an issue really. I'll have these two units of archers in place just in case. But we're going to take this relatively easily. Look at the timer. Oh my god, we're going to steal Canterbury from the English. Let's get that timer going. This is perfect. I've actually got an idea. Let's get the Hellweird bowmen up on the walls. I've actually got an idea here. Might be able to get a few pot shots on them before the time will be up. And they'll of course retreat once we take the settlement. Here we go, if I go back to normal speed. 74, we've taken one of them out. 2, 1, we've taken it. Continue the battle. This is perfect. And of course we own this, they can't actually get in I don't think. The gate's closed. They're just going to be wiped out. We've actually taken the settlement from them. Taken's probably too nice a word. We've stolen Canterbury from the English. And we've taken a general out in the same battle. This is perfect. I don't think they can walk in. Let's have a look. Let's see what happens. I don't think they can. Oh, they can. Okay, we're going to exit battle in that case. But we've won. A clear victory. Look at that. Only lost 33. We took out the one captain's army. We took 5 out of the other army. Got some prisoners as well. That was perfect. That will do for me. We won the battle. That's all that matters. And we've taken Canterbury in the process. And of course, I can sack Canterbury. Take the money. And we've stolen Canterbury from the English. And we took the fort as well. Look at that. Perfect, perfect turn for me. A bride has been presented to the king. Betrothed King Llewellyn the Honourable is Drusilla Ruhalon, a young woman. We're going to say yes. We'll get you as a bride so we can get the children on the way. Look at that. Welcome to the house. Construction complete. Leather tanner in Arundel. End of turn report. Look at that. Income, 20,000. Expenditure, 12. Profit of nearly 8,000. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Llewellyn, attack London. Oh, actually, I wanted to use that army to go bay. Oh, shit. Failed. Don't worry. Right, there was an army here. Let's go past there. It's fine. Not an issue. Right, this is perfect. The English are on the run. We've stolen Canterbury from the English. That was cheeky. Very cheeky, but who am I to judge? It was perfect. We barely lost any men in the pro... Ooh, Ireland are here. Look at that. Irish Navy are here. Interesting. Thing is now, they're going to be screwed. They'd be better off going for Arundel, but I'm not going to tell them what to do. We've taken this fort down here. We took out the English army at the fort. In that case, you're going to be pushed on. What sort of general are you? 54. Ooh. Push you on for now. We will probably move you towards Oxford. Keep this horse here for his free upkeep. Captain Redditch, I want to use you to look around this area, don't I? So, bingo, there you are, Captain Philip. I knew there's a large army here somewhere. I had to work out where you were. But now I have, let's see, Spy, go north. Spy can go to this town up here. Lincoln, Captain Robert, right, so we've got an idea of what's ahead now. Got my fort, I can actually besiege Nottingham. I wanted to use this army to take Nottingham, but instead, I'm going to be assaulting with the king. And I'm going to be taking London in this part as well. Night battle actually favours the English. So we're going to be fighting this ourselves. We have siege equipment to open the doors. And we have plenty of men to kill Englishmen. Let's go onto the battlefield, guys. We are going to take London. Here we go, this is it. London will burn. I'm actually going to exterminate the whole population in London as well. I did say on Twitter to Kassam187 that once I take London, I will be burning it down, and that is something I promised to do in this part. And right then, London, there it is. The gates of London. Let's get Ballista into position. Let's get the bowmen grouped up. Crossbowmen as well. Put them all into a formation. All infantry grouped up at the ready. Put them into a decent formation. And I have reinforcements on the way as well. And there's the king. King Llewellyn. Let's have a look at the king quickly. Let's have a little look. There he is. The proud man himself, King Llewellyn. Look at that beastly moustache. Gonna kill plenty of Englishmen today. Start the battle. Let's take that gatehouse. And this is perfect because we can outflank them. My reinforcing army is gonna be on the other flank. Gonna use as much fire as we possibly can muster. These are big walls to take as well. The capture point for London is all the way back here. They do actually have siege equipment of their own. And there are plenty of infantry. And there's the king. King Henry versus King Llewellyn. Four 4% damage. Fine by me. And let's go to the other side of the battlefield now. Where the rest of my men dwell. There they all are. And these are all waiting to come onto the field, look. Captain Caradog's men. Grouped up, all of them. How to best utilize these men. But they can't go through the gate, so they're probably best to just walk around. Very big settlement as well, London. They would be best to walk up here, I think, to be in a position to reinforce us. So if I save out here, they can just walk, casually walk up for now. That'd be great. 24% damage. Gonna fast forward. Use up as much ammunition that I possibly can to get that gate open. 52%. 56%. 80%. Come on, keep going, keep going. Need to take out their ballista as well. There we go. Perfect. Gate open. We're now going to be putting back normal speed. I'm going to attack their ballista and my infantry. Where are they? Here they are. They're actually going to be marching in. I'm going to go to here. They can walk into the building. Don't need to run. No point wasting energy on them. And get these to fire upon their ballista as well. But we've actually taken the gates. We've got the gates open. And they are going to be throwing their cavalry in by the looks of things. They are moving forward with the king and his billmen. I will be taking their king out in this battle. And fortunately, their trebuchet is going to be hitting their wall as well by the looks of things. So that's all okay by me. I'm actually going to be telling my crossbowmen to go onto the walls. And my hellwire bowmen and my scythier bowmen. They're all going to go to the walls. But most of this army which I have here as well has been in, with Clywelyn the whole campaign basically. These are all decent units to have. Won plenty of battles. And the king can come forward as well. No point dwelling back there. We have a settlement to take. And he is overshooting by quite a distance. Let's get the general forward actually. Just in case. Oh, we actually hit the tower there. We are a bit too close, I think. As a matter of fact, let's get the infantry here instead. I can actually attack the billmen once they come through the gate. No point throwing men in needlessly. Let's burn London to the ground. We're actually damaging the gate here as well, which is quite funny. Can't actually get over that wall. Oh shit. Let's get my general forward. Don't want to lose Llewellyn. That would be terrible at this stage of the campaign. These ballista shots are not doing very well. Let's go for the heavy build militia which are standing by there. Look. Might be able to take a few of them out. You can see what I'm trying to do. Oh, their bowmen. Heavy build militia have gone to the tower actually. It's fine by me because we can throw our units at them up there. I said I was going to burn this place down and I will be. Our infantry. The cavalry's going past, so we're going to go for the heavy build militia with everyone basically. Well, the English billmen can actually go for the general's bodyguard and the Myronoid spearmen. They can go for the general's bodyguard as well. They can throw themselves in. We are going to lose some, of course. Not a problem. Not much of a problem anyway. Here we go, spearmen versus cavalry. Let's kill the king. 31 altogether. The aim is to, of course, overpower them at the gates. I don't mind losing a couple of units here because we have plenty of men on the way. Hope they've actually damaged my catapult by the looks of things. Of course, they have artillery there as well. Don't want to lose my general. Keep Llewellyn alive if possible. Engaging the heavy bill militia at the moment. This isn't too bad. Although we've lost our unit crew. They were actually going to use the crew, the catapult crew, to attack the trebuchet because they can't actually pick up the catapult any longer. They could have damaged it. Bowmen are still firing upon the general's bodyguard. And in the horizon, you can probably see on the campaign, on the mini-map in the bottom corner, that I have my units marching slowly towards the battlefield. No point rushing them in. Let's kill them, come on. 15 remaining with the general's unit. This is good enough so far, I think. 49 remaining. 12 remaining. Of course, they got a whole unit up there as well. Not too concerned. This is good enough so far. Sight there, bowmen. They can hit the infantry for me. All the bowmen can actually go for the heavy bill militia now as well. How much cavalry? 6 remaining. Oh, I'll take this gatehouse. My reinforcements can actually run in now, I think, from here. And help me take this settlement. 1 remaining. The general's on his own. There's King Henry. Will we kill Henry? Kill the king, come on. Kill King Henry. Can't say his name. Take his head for me. He's beaten off loads of them. We got him. The king is dead. Long live the king. Get in there and reinforce. Catapult crew. Nearly there. They're gonna disrupt them at least. Stop them firing upon me. Which is all that needs to happen really. It's working well this is. Kill them all. Chase them down. Kill them all. Come on. Reinforcements are on the way. Not sending Llewellyn in yet until we've taken this gatehouse, because I don't want to lose horses needlessly to that tower, to that boiling oil. And then we're just chasing down the remaining Englishmen. Billmen are fighting to the death. Go. Building lost gateway. Not good. These build men are going to get cornered though. Look at all the units I have on the way. Holy crap. Llewellyn's going to take this settlement. Building captured. Victory! We've taken London. Let's kill them all. Need to be relentless. I'm going to be using these Gwent raiders to counteract the billmen. They're going to charge the other way. Cut them off and kill them. Here they come. Gwent raiders running in. And there we go. Death all around. The Welsh have taken London. And England have lost one of its main settlements, and the modern day capital of England and United Kingdom is now ours. Gonna end the battle there. That will do. Clear victory, of course. Over 1,000 men against 171. Well played. We've done it. We've taken London. Prisoners captured, of course. Ransom them. They reject it, and we've taken London, one of our key objectives in this campaign. Another English settlement is lost, and we are rampant at the moment, and like I promised, I'm exterminating the population to get 7,000 florins. Resistance is futile, that's what you get for crossing me. The merciless mauler, King Llewellyn the Honourable, plus 3 dread, and his stats at the moment are absolutely incredible. If we have a quick look. Let's just have a quick look at what he has. He has retinue, he has apothecary, dangerous toxins can be used by those who understand their secrets, increases the chances of having children, plus 4 to his general's hit points, and a veteran warrior, so he gets a plus 1 to personal security and a plus 1 to command when commanding infantry. But on top of that, he's faction leader, plus 1 command, plus 2 authority, plus 3 to personal security. Hero of Wales, plus 1 command, plus 2 authority, plus 3 to morale for all troops, plus 3 to command when fighting against English. He's a great commander, he's eager, Honourable Ruler, Knight Fighter, Merciless Mauler, Mostly Irrational, Confident Attacker, Can Tell a Tale, Likes the Dark, Budding Bureaucrat, and he feels appreciated. He has some fantastic traits. He's brave, and he's also scarred as well. So there we go. Fantastic, fantastic, fantastic all round. We're going to repair the large stone wall. We're going to retrain the Scythier Bowmen and the Gwent Raiders. And we can construct some Ballista Tower here. And we want maybe an Armourer. We can afford it, we'll go for an Armourer. I'm just going to look to see what we have and get a fairground, paved roads, communal farming would be useful perhaps. In an abbey. The abbey for the population would be useful as well. So we're going to get lots and lots of stuff in London. I'm going to actually put a lot of units in here. What I'm going to do, I'm going to go on to Llewellyn. I'm going to take out the mercenary crossbow monk. We don't need them anymore. I'm going to actually put the cavalry in London along with all the Maidenoeth spearmen. So Llewellyn's got a lot more infantry there now as well. You could do some bows as well. You can have the Hellwear Bowmen. And this pure infantry of English Billmen and Gwent Raiders is going to be going north to help Nottingham. That's what we're going to do there. And there we have it, guys. We have taken Canterbury and we have taken London in this part, and we've exterminated the English. I've been Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales. Thank you for watching. Until next time, goodbye.